Grazie Emma, s'il s'agissait d'un syndicat, il serait très fort. Mais quand même, merci à l'ambassadrice Catherine Colonna, Hans Colonna, et je suis heureux d'être ici à Palazzo Farnese. Ça a été une longue journée et je pense que tout le monde a aussi dans son cœur Stockholm, le peuple suédois qu'on doit rappeler, parce que ce qui s'est passé aujourd'hui à Stockholm, comme dans les dernières semaines et mois dans d'autres villes européennes et du monde, doit trouver notre solidarité. Et je voudrais aussi vous remercier pour cette opportunité. I'll switch to English. We will have as you know, the G7 in Taormina in a few weeks. I think it will be a very interesting summit for many reasons that you can easily imagine and understand. We are in a very challenging and changing world, and this will be one of the first opportunity after the American elections, the French elections, Brexit, the world changing, and this meeting will give us a sense of how this changement will have an impact in our political environment. But we will, in any case, try to keep the attention of this meeting not only in tackling the political international major issues, which obviously will be the center of the discussion. And so we will try to concentrate our attention in many, I would say, strategic issues, mostly concentrated on the lack of trust in the world citizens towards the world government. This is the very, very ambitious, central and key issue that the Italian presidency will try to put at the attention of the G7. This will mean many, many issues, from migration to inequalities, the new discussion about protectionism, the necessity of collective leadership in the global crisis, and the necessity to try to invest in sustainable and inclusive growth. When we are talking about inequalities, obviously one of the most obvious inequalities and discrimination is the discrimination against girls and women. Including migrants and refugees, especially in Africa. We Italians, when we think to these discrimination connected to migration, we are often thinking, for example, to young Nigerian girls and the human trafficking on young Nigerian girls going on in the Mediterranean and arriving in our country. But the general discrimination is the issue. Women are still less likely than men to find a job. Only half of the world's working age women are employed. And also, if women manage to find paid employment, it is more likely to be in the informal sector. And if they finally enter the formal labor market, they earn, on average, 3/4 as much as men, even with the same level of education and in the same occupation. So women and girls count for more than half of the world's population, and I believe that ensuring the healthy development and the full engagement of this half of the world's available talent pool is decisive if we want our societies and our companies to thrive. Tapping into the huge potential of women and girls can boost growth and reduce inequalities. Better opportunities for women promote diversity, reduce economic inequality around the world, and help mitigate the impact of demographics. So encouraging the full participation of women in public life and in the business world leads to better decision-making all around. It is a powerful game changer for any country. I'm looking forward to receiving proposals and policy recommendations from you to bring to the summit, and I'm taking for sure the proposal that Emma was mentioning before of this task force. I'm obliged to, in any case, it would be. But I'm not only obliged, I think it's a very, very interesting.
It's a pleasure.
It's a very interesting point, and I totally share the idea that with our Canadian colleagues, we can put the basis of this project in Taormina and then go on next year with the Canadian presidency in the future G7. As far as our presidency is concerned, we have made a choice. In Taormina, we want to adopt, I know you don't like the name, but a roadmap for a gender-responsive economic environment. It is something very serious that we are discussing in the preparation of the Taormina G7. It is a priority of ours. No doubt, it is not just an economic tool, it is also very important to end violence against women, because an economically independent woman is obviously less vulnerable and less exposed to violence. So I confirm this kind of commitment. I am ready to accept these ideas, the ideas coming from your meeting today and tomorrow. I am interested in what the task force Emma is proposing could propose to our meeting. I think that we are all convinced of the fact that women and girl success will make stronger our economies. We have a lot to do to reach this goal. We can't be easily optimistic, but it is something entering the G7 dynamics. And this is something, I think. And it is something we, as Italian presidency, are really committed to. Thank you very much. Merci. Grazie.
Oui, parce que je voulais te dire merci. Au nom de nous tous et toutes, je voulais remercier Martha, mais toi aussi, parce que...